This is a production of PBS 39.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Amy Burkett. In a recent survey, 46% of Pennsylvania's major roads were rated in poor or average condition. Another study found 42% of the state's bridges structurally deficient. Finding the funds to fix these problems isn't easy. Some possible solutions: leasing the turnpike, raising the gas tax, and reallocating other funds. Crystal Fisher has more on the issue.
Traveling Route I-80 to the Poconos for a weekend at a ski resort or in the opposite direction to New York for a Broadway show adds up these days. With Pennsylvania's gas prices over $3 a gallon, going on a weekend getaway is getting pricey. And now, trip costs may jump again.
But the bipartisan report came out that said we need about $1.7 billion to take care of Pennsylvania's decaying infrastructure, roads, and bridges.
Monroe County State Representative Mario Scavello believes that legislators should take another look at the existing budget before trying to find new ways to get more money.
We're using $600 million for other functions, for other things. The Office of the Budget, Governor's Budget, $6 million. Department of Revenue, $17.6 million.
And his list goes on. But Northampton County Representative Rich Grusella disagrees.
I'm always willing to take a second look, but I would have to disagree with Mario in one respect, and that is we're not going to find $1.7 billion going back and taking a look at the budget. We're just not going to find it.
When the report was released, some possible solutions surfaced, such as raising the gas tax, leasing the turnpike to an outside entity, and implementing toll booths on I-80, a plan enacted on the state level last July.
When I first heard about it, I laughed, and I basically said, this can't possibly go through.
Tom Smedley's the director of regional operations at Roadway Your Way in Tannersville. He says that adding tolls to I-80 will have a negative effect on Pennsylvania's economy.
Consumer goods, et cetera, throughout this whole region, and then out into the rest of the country as needed.
As Tom points out his region's coverage on the map, he explained that if trucking companies have to pay tolls both ways, it adds millions of dollars a year to their operating cost, which is ultimately passed down to the consumer.
It's also going to be money cost added into the companies we do business with. It's going to cost the Walmarts and the Targets more transportation costs. And then they're going to postpone that or transfer that down to you, to us, to we.
And it's going to cost them $200 to go from across the Commonwealth, across the state. They're going to look at secondary routes. So the 78s of the world, the 22s of the world, anyone going west is going to take other options.
But beyond money, Tom says his biggest fear is safety. He showed an example of a truck changing lanes with a car in the driver's blind spot and explained how changing lanes at toll booths greatly increases the chance of an accident.
With 10 toll booths proposed across Route 80, the lane changes as they approach the toll booth are going to be incredible. And the opportunity for an accident is 10 times.
Yeah.
10 toll booths.
Bill Gagey's the general manager of the Poconos Brewing Company, a restaurant, comedy, and sushi bar on Route 611, which runs parallel to I-80. He is concerned about the plan.
The biggest concern is going to be where they put the tolls in and how frequently they're going to toll. If it's going to be every exit that you have to pay to get on and off, that's going to have a tremendous impact.
On the flip side, Bill says if the exits aren't concentrated in Monroe County around local businesses, it shouldn't bother the brewing company.
If you're doing this for dollars and cents, you're going to put a toll in Monroe County.
The last figure, I believe, there's 77,000 vehicles that go through the Stroudsburg corridor on 80 per day.
Representative Scavello says he received hundreds of petitions from those very same business owners and residents that travel I-80 daily that were opposed to the plan. After an internet poll, Representative Grusella says 70% of the 300 constituents who voted were in favor of the plan. But both Grusella and Scavello agree that if the plan takes effect, placement of the tolls is key.
When you look at I-80 and the way the citizens of Monroe County use it, we use it as a local road. We'll jump on for an exit, jump off, go down a little further, jump on again. It's a local road.
If they can arrange the toll plazas so that they do not affect local traffic, which they say they can do.
The plan to toll I-80 now awaits federal approval. But in the meantime, Governor Rendell is still exploring the idea of leasing the turnpike. Another possible solution is raising the gas tax, which according to taxfoundation.org, Pennsylvania gas tax already nears the top of the nation's charts, standing at 32.3 cents per gallon and ranking fourth highest nationally.
People that I talked to just weren't interested. You know, they think the gas price is too high now. So if you tell them you're going to add another 15-cent tax, It's just not palatable.
In the meantime, while awaiting a federal vote, residents and business owners next to I-80 are left wondering what will happen. And only time will tell if Roadway will have to recalculate their costs, the small business owners at Line 611 may have to rethink traffic flow, and the budget for a weekend trip may include more toll costs. For Tempo, I'm Crystal Fisher reporting.